Everyone, welcome. Today, I'm a little bit tired. Katie Taylor versus Chantel Cameron has just ended about 20 minutes ago. I had recorded this video beforehand, but it didn't. The mic was terrible. The mic was, yeah, it sounded like the last video. So I've got it all fixed now. The mic's fixed. Everything's fixed. Let's quickly hop into why I haven't been recording. I haven't been recording because I've been quite busy. Personal issues. Just some personal things in general. I'm trying to get the house sorted, really. Not really been doing too much. Also been back to training myself. Been back to training boxing for myself. So that's my main focus right now. I'm not really going out, meeting people, seeing anyone. Just mainly just sticking myself into my boxing. Trying to help around the house, you know. Learn how to do things and be independent on my own. And all that. But that isn't what today's video is about. I'm a little bit tired as well, sorry. I've got monsters. I've just taken some tablets. Nothing I want to disclose. But they are not drugs. Like, I'm not high or anything. I'm just really tired. I'm about to drink some monsters and keep myself awake. Because we had the Benedivez card. The Benedivez and Benedivez Jr. card. Coming up in about under an hour now. I was thinking of streaming. I might still stream, but it's probably rare. It's because I haven't recorded in so long, so I really want to get a video out for you guys. And I really want to talk to you guys. But if not, we're going to record tomorrow about the Benedivez card. I'm not going to talk about the whole Katie Taylor card. I really just don't want to. There's nothing really much to go off of. You know, there's a few things that I will go, oh, that probably shouldn't have happened. All this and this. Like, I don't want to sit here and nitpick. Just for a disclosure, I've seen some of your comments saying this guy acts like he knows stuff. I do know some stuff, but I don't know everything. I'm not acting like I know everything. I'm just saying what I know. I'm saying what I think and saying what I feel. Some people say, oh, you can say what you think and feel. You have right to do that. And then as soon as you do it, they cry about it. It's like, you just told me I can, now you're crying about it. But let's get into today's video. Well, tonight's video, I should say. Katie Taylor versus Chantel Cameron 2 has just ended. And Katie Taylor has just had her hand risen. Did Katie Taylor deserve the win? My answer is yes, it is a deserved win. Could have gone either way. Very close fight. But my issues with the fight, I'm going to go into now. Right. My issues with the fight was not Katie Taylor. Right. The fight wasn't as entertaining. Katie Taylor did what she had to do, which was blitz, hold, and just repeat, really. That's what she had to do, you know. If Chantel Cameron wanted to trade, Katie Taylor would have won most exchanges. But Chantel Cameron hits harder. I believe Chantel Cameron hits a lot harder. Like, when you saw Katie Taylor get hit, you saw that the shots hurt. When Chantel Cameron got hit, you're like, okay, that dazed her a little bit because it was a bit quick, but it's not really that hurt. It's not like, oh, that really hurt me, I'm backing off. You know, Katie Taylor's good on the back foot. Katie Taylor's so good on back foot. But Katie Taylor did not look impressive tonight. In my opinion, she didn't look impressive tonight. I was not really entertained. One of the judges gave it 98-92. I completely disagree. What are you watching? You're watching the wrong fight. 96-94 to Taylor. I agree with that. And then the other judge gave it, what, 95-95 or whatever, as a draw. I agree. It was either a draw or a Katie Taylor win. I had Chantel Cameron win round one, round two, round four, maybe? I think four it was. Might have been longer than that. But, yeah, I had it draw. Round nine, I gave round nine a draw. So every single round up to that point made it a draw for me. And in round 10, I was like, look, whoever wins this one takes it. And Katie Taylor, I felt, took it. I felt like she wanted it a bit more in the end. But commentary was very biased. I was not a fan of commentary, to be honest. Commentary was like, oh my God, Katie Taylor's absolutely destroying her. Katie Taylor's baiting her. Like, I get they're seeing it from a different point of view. But it's like, where? Like, yes, Katie Taylor is a lot quicker, but those shots ain't landing. It's also ring control as well. It depends on how the judges are judging it. It doesn't matter how I'm judging it. It doesn't matter how you're judging it. It's how the judges are judging it. One of those judges definitely judged it on the point, the punches that were thrown, because they gave it to Katie Taylor. And if you're giving it to Katie Taylor, you've 100% given it to her just because she's thrown like 700 punches in a round. And to be fair to her, that is amazing. But yeah. I was also hoping this fight was going to go 3 minutes, because, as you know, so Amanda Serrano has just done 3 minutes, 12 rounds, so I was expecting these two to do it as well, but they didn't, so I was like, a bit weird. Katie Taylor said that, we need to go in Croke Park next. Honestly, no, please don't. Because, as Chantel Cameron said, she felt disrespected that she had to go back and fight on your turf because you wanted this fight on your turf, so you wouldn't accept the fight unless it was on your turf. It's like, she's the belt holder, she should decide where the fight is. And now you're going, no, we want to fight here again in the same arena we did last time. And then, yeah, you disrespected her, let's be honest. Also, commentary, please stop butt licking, it's fucking annoying. Like, I was sat there and they said, oh, she's battering Katie Taylor. I mean, Katie Taylor's battering Chantel Cameron. And all you see is Katie Taylor throw like 3 shots that missed, and then Chantel Cameron thrown like 2 that landed. And it's like, oh, my brain. But yeah, let's just say I wasn't happy with commentary. Katie Taylor wasn't as impressive. Chantel Cameron did what she had to do, you know. I really wish that she threw more uppercuts. I feel like the uppercuts were more her most deadly shot. I wish she stopped throwing hooks. She threw so many hooks. I was screaming on the TV. I was like, stop throwing hooks. Throw an uppercut. Who did I want to win? I wanted Katie to win. I did want Katie to win because it would make a trilogy, which is cool. But it's kind of like, you know, when I saw certain things, I was like, I don't know. But that's what I've really got. I don't really know what else to say about this. In the past video, I think I made up I said a lot more, but it's just, I'm forgetting a lot of things. I'm tired. I'm getting ready for the Benavidez fight. I'm probably not going to stream. I'm a bit tired. If I lighten up a bit, I'll stream, but I won't have as much energy. But I do miss talking to you guys, and hopefully next week we get to do more, because we have Ryan Garcia versus I don't remember who, and UFC returns, and PFL is back next week. I missed the PFL yesterday. I watched so many undercard fights and then missed the rest. But yeah, hope you guys enjoyed. Sorry for such a short video. Haters, if you're gonna hate, fuck off, because I just couldn't give a shit. If you want to hate, you can hate. I'm gonna reply to your comment, or I'm gonna ignore you, but your comment will stay. I'm not gonna block you or ban you. I'll let you have your fun, do whatever. But if you're gonna come in and be like, oh my god, you know nothing, yeah, you probably know nothing either, so don't fucking chat shit. But yeah, that's my thoughts, that's my opinions. Let me know what your thoughts are, let me know what your opinions are. Who you thought win, who you thought was the outcome. Also, check out my Instagram before tomorrow, because I posted something on Instagram on my story, also called my opinions on the fight when it was happening. So, yeah. Also, I know someone might ask me this. Did I believe that the first punch in the fight was a knockdown? Do I believe the knockdown in the fight was a knockdown? I believe it was, but maybe Chantel Cameron stepped on her foot or something and then jabbed her. But I saw a nice clean jab and she went down and the ref went no. I thought it was a bit stupid. Ref was a bit stingy in my opinion. But that's all I got. Hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you in a bit. Peace out, everyone.